Thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Charlene Israel.
And I'm Ephraim Graham. Tensions are high in the Middle East after Syria threatened to retaliate against Israel for airstrikes inside Syria. Israel says it targeted weapons that were headed for Hezbollah. CBN Middle East Bureau Chief Chris Mitchell has more.
Syria's foreign minister said Israel's alleged airstrikes on targets near Damascus are a declaration of war. Israel reportedly carried out two aerial strikes in 48 hours to destroy what were described as game-changing weapons. That includes advanced Iranian Fateh 110 missiles with a range of 180 miles. Iran was shipping them through Syria to Hezbollah in Lebanon. The attacks highlighted growing Iranian involvement in Syria and the region. The feeling here in Jerusalem is that any retaliation will be decided in Tehran by Iran's mullahs, rather than in Damascus by the Assad regime.
Syria cannot retaliate without an approval of Iran and also Hezbollah. Only Iran can approve because Iran is a great supporter sending the weapons.
Israel moved Iron Dome anti-missile batteries to protect northern Israel. But on Monday, Israelis on the Golan Heights and elsewhere were taking the situation in stride. Officially, the Israeli government has neither confirmed nor denied the airstrikes. Israeli Tourism Minister Uzi Landau said it was Israel's policy not to allow a certain kind of weapon to reach the hands of terrorists. Beyond that, many question how the U.S. should respond.
The whole situation is becoming more and more expansive, and unfortunately, the red line that the President of the United States written was apparently written in disappearing ink.
I think the President needs to make it clear what we will do, and he's already tried to do that with his bright red line, which he hadn't followed through on. So I don't know what his steps should be right now, but clearly his indecisiveness has destabilized and probably brought Israel into this.
For now, the bloody civil war in Syria continues, and Iran's power is increasing. But after the weekend attacks, it's clear Israel is ready to act if it feels its security is threatened. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Meanwhile, the Obama administration is not commenting directly about the airstrikes. The White House spokesman says Israeli concern is justified and it's working in close coordination with Israel.
Here at home, President Obama says he'll try again to pass gun control laws. Leaders of the NRA say the gun lobby is ready for a long war. The National Rifle Association held its annual convention in Houston this weekend. Mark Martin has the convention wrap-up.
The NRA and gun control opponents won the first round against the White House with the defeat of the gun control bill in the U.S. Senate last month.
A Senate vote less than 2 weeks ago is significant.
However, NRA leaders are taking it one step at a time, not becoming overly optimistic.
We must never confuse winning a battle with winning the war.
And explaining why Americans should own a firearm.
Guns save lives. Guns protect our mothers, our wives, our daughters, our children.
The NRA focused its criticism at President Obama's push for new gun control laws.
You know, Obama is meeting and plotting with the who's who of the gun ban movement.
NRA leaders also targeted New York Mayor Bloomberg's more than $10 million investment to help prevent illegal guns from getting on the streets.
And we will never be scared of a billionaire.
For gun control supporters, a former White House aide recommends following the NRA's strategy.
Organize as the NRA does and make it a voting issue.
The White House continues to reference the innocent children of Newtown, Connecticut and their grieving parents.
And all I can remember is that awful day.
That strategy did not work in the fight for background checks in the Senate. So this weekend, victims of gun violence confronted NRA members at their own convention to try to find common ground. In the meantime, the White House will continue to push Congress. The Obama administration also continues to look into what the president might be able to do on his own to bypass congressional approval. Mark Martin, CBN News.
President Obama is embarking on a tour of several U.S. cities to tell Americans his focus is still on the economy, even though he's trying to pass sweeping gun control and immigration laws. That comes as a new poll shows the American public has a pessimistic outlook on the economic recovery and the president's handling of it. Only one in four Americans expect his or her financial situation to improve over the next year. That is according to a new AP-GFK poll. The negative outlook of the public is hurting President Obama's approval rating. Only 46% of Americans approve of how he's handling the economy. 52% disapprove. This is the third year in a row that the nation's economic recovery has slowed in the spring. Several recent economic reports show slowdowns in hiring, consumer retail spending, manufacturing activity, and economic growth.
President Obama's inability to work with Republicans in Congress continues to be an issue as his second term in office starts heating up, bringing up questions of his leadership. Lee Webb recently spoke with Regent Law Professor Dr. Charles Dunn and his congressional leadership class. Dunn is the author of the book, The Seven Laws of Presidential Leadership. We wanted to know how he thought the president is doing.
A president's legacy is largly determined by how well he leads, particularly in tough times. Author and professor Charles Dunn rates four presidents at the top of his leadership list: Washington, Lincoln, Franklin Roosevelt, and Ronald Reagan.
At this stage of President Obama's tenure in the White House, how would you assess his leadership?
He gets a failing grade for presidential leadership, especially as related to the Congress. And the Congress is, of course, the institution that passes the bills that become law. And that's where I have to grade him much lower than I would like to. In other areas, I would rate him much higher. For example, the law of rhetoric, he handles rhetoric pretty well. But if we look at the law of history, he's elected to represent the whole of the American people. He's the only person who does. I have to rate him very low on that because he has conducted a strategy of divide and conquer.
Dunn believes Obama's health care mandate is a good example of that strategy. A recent Rasmussen poll finds that 49% of voters view the health care law unfavorably, while 47% support it. That poll is echoed among Dr. Dunn's students.
He had all the votes he needed. He had 60 votes in the Senate. He had overwhelming majorities in the House. So he didn't need Republicans to get anything done. And as a result, you have this massive piece of legislation that has overhauled 1/6 of the American economy without any buy-in from half of America, essentially.
Dunn points to a speech the president made at a shipyard back in March when the sequester deadline loomed.
You don't want to have to choose between, do I close funding for the disabled kid or the poor kid? Do I close this Navy shipyard or some other one?
Dunn believes those tough decisions are what presidents are elected to make.
Again, look at those great presidents. The tough decisions that Washington made in forming this country and the presidency, the tough decisions Lincoln made, tough decisions that Franklin Roosevelt made, the tough decisions that Ronald Reagan made. Making tough decisions is one of the key criteria in determining the rank of presidential greatness.
And he believes President Obama's leadership strategy during his first term will come back to haunt him.
When President Obama won office, I spoke very highly of him as a person with great potential. But we have this big gap between promise and performance. It's a credibility gap. And that's what's showing now as his poll numbers are plummeting.
Lee Webb, CBN News.
The days of tax-free online shopping may soon come to an end. The Senate will vote on a proposal today empowering states to collect sales tax for internet purchases. Currently, states can require retailers to collect sales tax if the store has a physical presence there. As a result, many online sales are tax-free, giving internet retailers an advantage over local stores. A broad coalition of retailers favor of the new measure. Republicans in the House oppose it and regard it as a tax increase. The measure is expected to pass the Senate.
Obamacare could cause thousands of very sick people to lose insurance coverage. The pre-existing condition insurance plan is a lifeline for those considered uninsurable. But the program is in danger because the federal government has capped spending at $5 billion. That leaves states with the rest of the bill. In a letter to the Health and Human Services Secretary, a leading state health official said enrollees also appear to be at risk of increases in both premiums and out-of-pocket costs that may continue enrollment cost prohibitive. He also warned of large-scale enrollee terminations.
The Kentucky General Assembly has passed a law allowing a Christian-only health care plan to resume operations in the state. The Florida-based MediShare ministry was shut down last year after objections from the Kentucky Insurance Department. The plan helps pay medical bills for Christians who don't smoke, drink, or engage in sex outside of marriage. The new law exempts the ministry from regulations that apply to traditional insurance companies. Participants will be required to sign a notice that they are aware that payment of their medical bills is not guaranteed. The new law takes effect June 25th.
A Kentucky school says prayer will not be a part of its graduation ceremony this year. The ban comes after six graduating seniors objected to prayers during the commencement ceremony. One of those students says he is an atheist and doesn't believe religion should be forced on him. But senior class president Jonathan Hardwick is speaking out against the ban. He says that while the school may not sanction it, officials can't stop him from praying.
Coming up, a South African preacher comes to the U.S. Hear Angus Buchan's message to 10,000 men.
Today we're on a field trip to discover what inflation is doing to our paper money. In this hand is a $20 bill, and in this hand is a $20 U.S. gold coin. They used to have the same buying power, but how much can they buy today? In this first basket is what my $20 bill buys: milk, bread, peanut butter, and jelly. And here's what one $20 gold coin will buy: six baskets full, worth nearly $2,000, almost 100 times more food, simply by owning gold dollars instead of paper dollars. History shows that the gold coins have been the best way to beat the rising cost of living. So class, the moral is that unless you want to live on peanut butter and jelly sandwiches in the future, you should turn some paper dollars into gold coins now. How and why is explained in a new book, The Great Debasement. Call the number below for a totally free copy. And that's the simple truth.
Help!
If an emergency happened right now, you can have help at the push of a button with Medical Alert.
Remember when I took that fall, Mary?
Oh, yes, that was terrible.
Yes, it was.
Help!
And I thought, what if you hadn't been there? I ordered my Medical Alert the next day.
I can't describe how safe I feel now with my Medical Alert. You didn't know I was wearing it, did you?
Medical Alert is easy to install, waterproof, and covers you inside your home and out.
It helps me feel safe from fires, break-ins.
And of course, a Medical Alert. And if you don't have a home phone, don't worry. They have that covered.
There's always help at the push of a button. Don't wait till you need it.
Get Medical Alert for less than a dollar a day. There are no long-term contracts. Order now and get your second button free. Call for your free brochure.
For your free Medical Alert system with second button free, call 800-575-8507.
From CBN.
Broken Eardrum is playing at the Civic tonight.
And you'll just have to miss it.
This is so incredibly unfair.
A special story of love and sacrifice.
Joy, Mom comes up with something.
Christopher Quantum. You and I are going to discuss your attitude right this minute.
Superbook!
No!
Join the Superbook DVD Club and get Superbook's newest episode, He Is Risen, plus two copies to share with others, all for your gift of $25.
They have arrested Jesus, the Messiah. Do you not know that I have the power to crucify you?
No! Please! You can't!
They've taken him to Golgotha. We must hurry.
Mary is about to lose her son. The worst thing any mother could face. I am not leaving her.
Superbook. It's an amazing way to build a strong spiritual foundation in the children you love.
Mary, who are you looking for?
I've seen him. He is alive.
Superbook. He is risen. Available now.
A California church says it will no longer sponsor a Boy Scout troop in its facilities if the national organization lifts its ban to openly gay scouts. Pastor Robert Hall of Calvary Chapel Rio Rancho said he knows other pastors who will do the same. The Boy Scouts of America has submitted a plan to allow gay scouts, but not gay scout leaders. Hall took part in a webcast hosted by the Family Research Council Sunday to rally opposition to a vote on that plan May 23rd. The Mormon Church has approved the plan.
Thousands of men packed a Tennessee arena this weekend for an historic meeting. It was South African evangelist Angus Buchan's first men's conference in the United States. But he told the men their struggles aren't much different than the men he preaches to back at home and around the world.
There is a tangible excitement inside this Tennessee sports arena.
Oh, joy. I'm looking for something that's just magnificent. That's what I've been all day. Is I've been waiting on to come here, you know, just to see what I'm going to get. I'll pray to get.
Will Wade is one of 10,000 men who've united to pray, worship, and hear a word from Angus Buchan, a South African cattle farmer turned evangelist, whose life story has now been the focus of two films, Faith Like Potatoes and Angus Buchan's Ordinary People.
What's your message to American men tonight?
Okay, my message to the American men tonight, hot off the press, okay, is that we've got to speak the truth. Thy word is truth. This is my agricultural manual. I'm telling you, Ephraim, people laugh at me. This is the book that tells you to love your wife, submit to your husband, respect your elders. This is the book that says a lazy man doesn't deserve to eat. This is the book that says a fair day's work for a fair day's pay. And when we get back to the truth, then we'll have a revival.
The future of this nation is hinging on the family.
Buchan calls his massive meetings Mighty Men's Conferences.
This is Angus Buchan's first Mighty Men's Conference in the U.S. The first was born on his farm in South Africa with just 40 men. The final meeting on that farm drew some 400,000 men.
It's not the government, it's not the White House, it's the family.
The cries of men in this arena are loud, and each has a struggle he's praying to overcome.
I'd say the peer pressure of my peers, like people at school doing things that I shouldn't do and not doing them.
But the men aren't the only focus here tonight.
You know, a lot of ladies have given me stick back home. You know, are you a male chauvinist? I said, no, I'm not. I can't even spell the word. I said, these meetings are not for the men. They're actually for the women and the children, to teach the man to be prophet, priest, and king in his home. Okay, prophet, lead the way, from the front, not from the back. Okay, priest, to lead his children and his wife in the things of God every day. Okay, and king, to put the bread on the table.
That conference was sponsored by World Outreach Church in Murfreesboro, and those 10,000 men left with books and instruction on where to go next so that it doesn't die at that meeting.
Up next, Nigeria on the brink as radical Muslims attack Christians in the north. Some fear a civil war is in the making.
Attention, sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans. with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right. You could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
News you want, when you want, 24/7. Stay current with up-to-the-minute stories.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, New York.
I don't have to wait for my news anymore.
CBNNews.com, at your fingertips all day long.
I only watch the stories I want to see.
I find the story, I click on it, and boom, I'm there.
Embassy in Washington, Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News.
The source for your news, CBNNews.com.
Authorities in Malaysia are investigating the murder of an American pastor in Kuala Lumpur. The Reverend David Ginter, seen here with his wife and two adopted children, grew up in Portland, Oregon, in the Portland, Oregon area. He's been in Malaysia since 2010, serving as a pastor of Bridge International Church. Friends found him in his home Saturday with his hands and legs bound and a cell phone charger wrapped around his neck. His car was missing. Police say they have no motive or suspects in that crime.
A bomb blast at a church in the African nation of Tanzania killed one person and injured dozens more. Eyewitnesses said a motorcyclist tossed the bomb into a Catholic church in Arusha. The motorcycle driver has been arrested. The Vatican ambassador to Tanzania was in the church to celebrate its official opening. He was not hurt. Officials say they don't know the motive behind this attack, but in recent months, Muslim extremists have carried out attacks against Christians in Tanzania.
10 people died in an attack on a church and a local market in northern Nigeria Sunday. Last year, more Christians were killed in Nigeria than in any other country. Senior international correspondent Gary Lane tells us why Nigerian believers are targeted and what can be done to help them.
Bombings like this one gave Nigeria the sad distinction of the nation with the highest Christian death toll. More than 900 Christians reportedly were killed in Nigeria last year, victims of the Boko Haram terrorist group and other Islamic militants.
They are so radical that they do not even spare Muslims. If Muslims are sympathetic to any cause at all, if they are sympathetic to the Christians' cause or the minorities' cause, they are also termed as, you know, infidels.
In 2013, radicals have killed more than 120 Nigerians, most of them Christians. Gregory Lahr is an international human rights attorney.
It is happening now at this time because there appears to be a new resurgence, a new Islamic awareness on the need to further propagate their religion.
Because of this wave of violence, various groups in southern Nigeria are taking up arms to protect the Christians. Attorney Emmanuel Ogebe warns the country may be on the brink of a broader conflict.
Because of the massive Christian-Muslim population in Nigeria, there's no country on earth that is as rich and ready for a religious war. All the elements, all the ingredients are there.
Ogebe spoke at a recent conference sponsored by the Washington, D.C.-based Jubilee campaign. Some panelists criticized the U.S. State Department's reluctance to blame the violence in Nigeria on Islamic extremism.
The route they are taking is dangerous. It's against American interest, and it's not positive. It's not sensible. The ultimate aim of this is extremism. It's not just to wipe out Christians. It will hit back here ultimately.
For years, Islamic militants limited their attacks on Christians to the 12 northern Nigerian states where Sharia law is in place. Now they're pressing into central and southern states where Christians are in the majority. World Magazine reporter Mindy Bell says the pattern is all too familiar.
We've seen it happen in Sudan. We've seen it in Mali. We've seen it in parts of the Middle East and other parts of North Africa. When that happens, what is growing up in there are also the seeds of terrorism that is targeting the West.
So what is the solution to stop the attacks against Christians and others? Nigerian President Goodluck Jonathan has proposed a possible amnesty for Boko Haram terrorists. Stefanos Foundation founder Mark Lipto says amnesty would be a mistake.
It goes to say that the government must have to succumb to the pressure of terror. And then we see that it will go in to reward the perpetrator to continue to carry out his carnage. That is wrong.
The problem has gone beyond Nigeria alone. Like, it actually has its roots in Mali, in Libya. So even if the Nigerian situation is well contained and the borders are not secure, you have not solved the problem.
Lipto suggests Christians united in prayer can make a difference.
What we see is disunity that has taken on the church. And so the voiceless are not being represented. But if we look to the person Christ and avoid all these differences and come together, we will be able to give a voice to the voiceless. And that is what we're called to do.
Gary Lane, CBN News.
Tough, but at least we know we are called to give a voice to the voiceless, as he said. So we must continue to shine a light on that.
And pray, definitely.
And pray, indeed.
Stay with us. We'll be right back.
When you're driving along and your cell phone rings, do your eyes instantly go off the road? Then you need to get a grip. Hi, David Jones here with the new GripGo, the most versatile hands-free mount that will instantly grip any phone for safe driving. Just attach the suction cup to your windshield or dash, and GripGo grabs your phone ultra fast, that it peels right off. And don't worry, there's no sticky residue left behind. The 360-degree pivoting mount allows you to always get the perfect viewing angle.
It's even strong enough to grab and hold this expensive smartphone out the window, yet it comes right off with ease. That's the advantage of GripGo.
You can get the amazing GripGo with dashboard mount for only $14.95. We'll send you a second kit free. Just pay separate processing and handling. Get two complete GripGo systems for just $14.95.
To order GripGo for $14.95 plus processing and handling, call 1-800-709-5259 or order online at getgripgo.com.
Jim is 38, mortgage, married, three great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? $60? $40? Actually, none of the above. Jim can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $19 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll comparison shop the pick of insurance companies like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. Jim's wife, Deidre, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote. We shop. You save.
Oh, Ephraim, remember the sounds of the ice cream truck?
Oh, I do.
Well, local ice cream trucks reminds us of that summer is almost here.
Indeed, indeed. But the happy tunes have landed on a sour note in one New York neighborhood. Believe it or not, there is an ice cream war brewing in the city of Gloversville. Police say that a rival truck has been harassing the local ice cream man, coming up behind him, blaring loud music, and offering free treats. They say it's gone way beyond friendly competition.
It is a rather unique situation. One of our officers actually witnessed one of the ice cream trucks following the other ice cream truck. He had two vehicles, two ice cream trucks, and they were both engaged in that course of conduct.
Police later arrested the rival driver on stalking and harassment charges. They say it just goes to show how serious some people take their ice cream. I tell you.
That's it for us on the CBN News Channel.
See you tomorrow.
If you had a choice between going bald and a full head of hair, which would you choose? Advances in medical science have resulted in the world's first and only permanent solution to hair loss.
Yes!
You wash it, you cut it. It's your own real Naturally growing hair. When it comes to hair restoration, no one in the world has more experience than Bosley. The results look completely natural and are affordable on nearly any budget. But the entire process can't be explained in 60 brief seconds. So to find out more about this clinically proven and permanent solution to hair loss, call now to receive your free, no obligation information kit. It'll answer all of your questions about hair loss and hair restoration. Plus, we'll also send you this $250 gift certificate just for calling. Every day you wait, you're losing more hair. So don't put it off any longer. You owe it to yourself to find out the facts. Choose hair. Choose Bosley.
Call 800-868-9957. That's 800-868-9957.
Introducing the CBN Bible from CBN.com. Now, an easier way to study the Bible and grow in your faith. Highlight your favorite verse. Read separate versions at a glance. Click and read a commentary. Or cross-reference your favorite verse using the Strong's Concordance. All the right tools to study the Bible, all in one place. The CBN Bible, available at cbn.com/Bible or the iTunes App Store.